seriously, what the f*** are you doing?
All right, begin.
What's going on YouTube and welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are having a great Sunday so far. Guess what? It's Super Bowl Sunday. Drop down in the comments and let me know who you rolling with. Are you rolling with the Chiefs or are you rolling with the Bucks? I'm rolling with the Bucks over here, baby. Now, I want to talk about this girl that has went viral for using Gorilla Glue to actually style her hair.
Hey, y'all. For those of y'all that know me know, my hair has been like this for about a month now. It's not by choice. No, it's not by choice. When I do my hair, I like to, you know, finish it off with a little Got to Be Glue spray. You know, just to keep it in place. Well, I didn't have any more Got to Be Glue spray, so I used this. Gorilla Glue spray. Bad idea. Y'all, look, my hair, it don't move. You hear what I'm telling you? It don't move. I've washed my hair 15 times and it don't move. Stiff wear. Woo! My hair. So I'm going to tell y'all like this. If you ever run out of Got to Be Glue spray, don't ever use this.
Honda BBBBI shot attack.
Honda BBBBI shot attack.
Honda BBBBI shot attack.
Honda BBBBI shot.
BBBI shot.
Well, I thank God.
All right, so I just learned today that after dealing with this for quite some time, she decided to go to the ER and seek some medical help in regards to the Gorilla Glue that's stuck in her hair. And so while I do empathize with her, I have to call her out for trying to go viral. There is no way in the world that, you know, going viral, you can be so hell-bent on going viral that you will go to your platform and let them know that you made such a poor choice and put that type of adhesive in your hair just to style it. You didn't think about actually consulting someone like your mom or a hairdresser before you did such a thing? Gorilla Glue? Really? Like, what would make you want to admit to your platform? And this is the thirst of just going viral, y'all. This is just the thirst of going viral. That's something that she should have kept to herself, but maybe she thought that she was going to get paid for her pain. Now, I want to give her a shout out for having some nerves, because for you to come to your platform and admit this stupid mistake, this ignorant mistake that you made, and then you have the nerve enough to try to give people some advice to never put Gorilla Glue in their hair. You know, this was advice to other women. I'm pretty sure that a lot of women out there have common sense enough to know not to put Gorilla Glue on their hair. And then they're going to have the common sense enough to know not to actually put something in their hair without reading the label or the instructions. Nothing on the bottle or the spray bottle of Gorilla Glue has anything that says you can apply this to your hair. I mean, come on, it's just common sense. Now, I'm not gonna go off on a limb and call her out of her name. A lot of people were definitely joking on her and saying some disparaging things in regards to the mistake that she made. But I will stand by what I said, and I believe that this was a poor choice. It was stupid in my estimation. Now, everybody makes mistakes, and I get that. But the most important thing that I wanna say is that going viral should be secondary when it comes to your health, you know? You know, there's no way in the world I would be thinking about going viral and letting my fans know that I made such an egregious mistake just because it can get me followers. At the end of the day, more people are going to become interested in me, and this can help me build my brand, because, you know, a lot of people follow stupidity. Now, I hope that, you know, everything is all right. I hope that she finds some peace and some comfort, because she has been going through a lot. And like I said, I do empathize with her. You know, I want everything to turn out fine. You know, I know that she's probably going to go through a lot of stages where, you know, she has to regain her form as far as, like, you know, her hair and things of that nature. So we just hope that there is no permanent damage when it comes to, you know, the quality of her hair and things of that nature. Now, there was a dermatologist that offered some advice to her prior to her going to the emergency room. I want you guys to check out what he had to say, and then I'll be back to close the video.
Absolutely awful for this person. She made the decision to use Gorilla Glue spray in her hair instead of hairspray because she was out thinking maybe it would last just a little bit longer and she'd still be able to wash it out. But Gorilla Glue spray is incredibly durable and doesn't wash out easily. So what would you do according to a dermatologist? The first thing that you can do is use acetone. Acetone can help to break the bonds of the glue. Acetone is safe to put on the skin. It can be irritating, it can be drying, but trying to break down those bonds. I would go to a professional hair salon and let them help you apply the acetone and work it through the hair. You probably still want to see a dermatologist just in case you're getting any irritation on the scalp after all of these treatments. There's another product called Goo Gone. That one is not necessarily safe to use on the skin, but if the acetone doesn't work sufficiently, I would go ahead and give that a try. Try to keep it in the hair only and then see a dermatologist to take care of any irritation on the scalp.
Alright, so the main thing and the most important thing at this point is that she finds some comfort. And I'm just praying for her that everything works out in her favor. I still stand by what I said. I feel that, you know, she should have had the common sense to read the label, to reach out to other people and ask them, do you think this would be a good idea for me to put Gorilla Glue in my hair? But she didn't. But I'm not going to just, you know, carry on and say the things that I've seen on social media in regards to this young lady. I wish her the best, but I just want to emphasize that going viral is not that serious, man. Going viral is not that serious, especially when it comes down to the quality of your health, the quality of your skin, you know, the quality of your hair. Why would you forfeit, you know, those wonderful attributes that God blessed you with, and then you're going to use your shortcomings just to go viral? Like, if people out there think that the amount of social media following that you have, the amount of people that gravitate towards your content actually validates you, then I'm sorry, you have a self-esteem issue. And that's something that you need to work on. That's something that you may, you know, need to go and see somebody about to talk about, you know, why do other people make you feel validated? You know, because I don't feel that way over here. I'm very confident, as you should be. But anyway, I'm gonna let this go and let y'all have that in the comments. Drop down and let me know what you think about this entire story. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll get with you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace.